Hey guys in the fridge. Oh god, I screw up my freaking intro again. Hey guys in the fridge. You know what? I'll never cut that. So hey guys, right in the fridge, and welcome to the video. In this video, I'm going to be reviewing my first Robots in Disguise Transformer. And this is Scorponok. And it's on sale when I bought it. So that is why I bought it. So, Scorponok is a warrior's class. That is what it says on the box. It is a warrior's class. Or a warrior class if you want to. Figure. And this guy's solid when I pick him up. It's solid, you know? It doesn't have any shaky parts, except for the legs. They're so loose after like how many months? 3 months, I guess. And, yeah. So accessories, we have a sword. This pirate sword. So that is all the accessory. Only one sword. Well, I can make something custom with this gun. So to attach it, this is a square, not square hole, like a round hole in a round fist. Just peg it right there. There you go. So let's see the articulation of this guy. Head can move up that far and look, it can look down that far. It cannot look side to side because of the neck, but it can rotate 360 because it is in a ball joint. You can just pop it and you can see the ball joint. And the arms, you have a bicep swivel, a ball jointed shoulders and a ball joint, a bicep swivel, more than 90 degree bend, very nice. And you can just literally broke his arm. No wrist swivel or anything. No waist articulation. The hips are thigh. I mean, this is a the hips is on a ball joint and a swivel, so it can kick that far. It can move back that far. Hip swivel here. I'm making a Jabba Dee Hong reference here. And yeah, the knees, they are chicken legs. They can, there's a hinge here, another hinge here. And so if I'm poses that you really want though. No feet articulation except for down due to transformation.
Okay.
So that is it for the possibility. It is really weak in possibility. Yes, I said that right. It's weak in possibility. Yeah, I cannot speak English right now. So we can have a really good pose in this guy, at least. There you go. That guy looks good. So, let's get into transformation, shall we? First, take the scorpion tail, move that back, and hinge this forward. And put your sword in the hole right there. or peg hole, if you want to say it like that. And yeah. Now, rotate the arms. What should we call it? 90 degrees. And bend it over 90 degrees. Not all 90 degrees, but not all like that. Like this. And tab this shoulder piece. It is tabbing right here and it is slotted right there. Like that. Now, open the claws like that and swing the arm and connect it into the claw and close everything up. And there you go. You have one arm done. Do the same for the other side. Rotate it, bend it 90 degrees, over 90 degrees, and you know, squeeze everything up. Now, Bulk Matrix, I guess, have a review of this guy, and he said that this is the boxing mode. But yeah, you can definitely so. This is a boxer mode because of the boxing gloves. But anyway, moving right along. Camera. Moving right along. Now, make it pointing like that. Now, open up his chest, rotate the head, push back the head, and get the scorpion head out until it clicks into place. And down here, there's a hinge here. There's a double hinge. You can see that. Right there. You need to hinge it forward. Like that. Then you can now snap the robot body in the scorpion body. Now for the legs. Now this is cool. I do this in like... I do the legs like this. I collapse the feet down, then straighten it up and rotate it at this thigh rotation, I guess. I mean the hip rotation, and hinge it in the second hinge right here until it is not snapped but flush to the body. Not flush like that. And now this peg right here goes into this slot or whatever you want to call it. Mine, after like 3 months, it doesn't stick in properly. What am I doing wrong? What am I doing wrong? It should be clean. Okay. Now, here we go. It is now flush. Now, do the same thing with the other leg. Close that back up, rotate it, and peg it right there. Now, spread his scorpion legs, and there you have it. Here you have Scorponok in his robot mode. What did I say, I guess? Robot mode? Robotic scorpion mode. There we go. Now, this mode is pretty cool, but not as cool as my Grimlock. Oops, sorry, spoilers. So, I would rather be happy with Scorponok when you got it in fresh out of the box. But me, Grimlock, supreme. Okay, Grimlock. Crap it. Okay, so possibility and paint job is nice. My possibility wise is. The tail is on a ball joint, hinge drag right here and hinge drag right there. And a rotation at the sword. Legs can move up and down, not independently. Independently, I don't know what I'm saying like that. And the arms can move like that, can move backwards, can rotate. But if you rotate this ball joint connector, it can go like farther. Like that. And there you have it. That is Mr. Scoppernock review. And next up, tomorrow, Grimlock is being reviewed. Peace, guys.